Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl, one of my favorite movies. But one of the things I want to jump into in this analysis is analyzing the curse of the Black Pearl. Because you notice in these sci-fi fantasy epics, whenever there's a curse, there's a pattern. Started by the same kinds of things, ended by the same kind of things. Welcome to Durbania. I'm Durbin, and this is my theological analysis of the curse of the Black Pearl. I do find it fascinating when you go into sci-fi fantasy movies, it feels like as we artistically represent curses in any fashion, whenever we start writing about it and things like that, there's something inside, like maybe a truth that we know that comes out in that writing. A curse is usually begun by human selfishness, and it is usually ended by some kind of self-sacrifice paid in full that releases from the curse, whether the land or the people or whatever. So when you look at Curse of the Black Pearl, what brought on the curse was this crew's own greediness, their own lust, their own whatever.
Compelled by greed, you were, but now we are consumed by it.
And it's so interesting to me, again, that this is always the kind of thing that brings on the curse, because it feels like part of the curse isn't just the fact they turn into these skeleton people in the moonlight. Part of the curse is the fact that now their desires are never going to be satisfied.
The drink would not satisfy. Food turned to ash in our mouths. And all the pleasurable company in the world could not slake our lust.
What fascinates me about this whole idea of, you know, now they're consumed by greed, now they're consumed by lust, now they're consumed by those things, it reminds me of like the real life curse of sin. Exactly what sin does. Sin awakens desires. And then you think by yielding to it, whether yielding to lust or yielding to greed or yielding to envy or yielding to those things, you think if you just yield to it, you'll finally get the freaking relief of the pull and the weight that it brings on you. But really what it turns out sin does is it makes that desire stronger. So you yield to envy, you become more envious. You yield to lust, no matter what you do, you can't satisfy it with what you watch, what you do, it can't be satisfied. It feels like the pull gets stronger. You yield to greed, you just are hungry and thirsty for more and more, whatever, whether it's money, whether it's power, whether it's a position. It's like the more you yield to sin itself, the stronger its hold becomes. And that's where its great lie is. It presents the temptation. You will find your satisfaction right here. But all it does is it makes the desire stronger and satisfaction ever escapes. And that's the curse that the pirates are under in Curse of the Black Pearl. Yeah, they turn into weird, scary skeleton people who can't be killed. But that's the other thing. They can't even be killed. So they can't even be relieved of the curse. They can't be relieved of their desires even that way. So it's like this curse, all it did was they yielded to the worst parts of themselves, and the worst parts of themselves gave them no satisfaction. Instead, the worst part of themselves cursed them and got them trapped, and now they'll never find that satisfaction. So if they want to be relieved from the curse, what does it take? A blood payment. I mean, so many times when you go back through fantasy, when you go back through fiction, for a curse to be removed, it takes a sacrifice. Or if you go to Disney, it's True Love's Kiss. I'm gonna look at that again in real life. I mean, that whole curse of sin laid on mankind, the only thing able to set man free is a blood payment. But because we're the ones trapped in it, we're the ones constantly going in the cycle, we can't pay it. Like, we are the ones trapped and tainted. And because we are the ones that are tainted, we have no ability to give the payment to relieve us of the curse. So it took somebody who wasn't tainted by it, who wasn't ensnared or trapped by it, to become it, to set us free from it. I look at what he did on the cross, kind of like a marriage. When I married my wife, everything that was mine became hers. All that was hers became mine. And so that same thing with Jesus on the cross, he was establishing a relationship between us and him where everything that is ours become his. Like our curse, our sin, our war, our greed, our lust, our whatever, you name it, it became his. He became it. He paid for it in full. And all that was his innocence, his purity, his peace, his joy, all of that stuff then became ours. It was an amazing exchange that occurred. So it took the sacrifice of innocent blood to set us free of that curse. And that was the whole thing of what he did. So just like you see in Jack Sparrow, where Jack Sparrow basically, to keep Barbossa distracted so that the good guys could win and do what they needed to do, he had to steal a piece of that treasure and take the curse on himself. And at the end, it took that blood payment to release the curse from everybody altogether. Same thing with Jesus. He literally became the curse, took it on himself through the payment of his own life, released us from the curse. And I feel like that's why when we look at fantasy, when we look at fiction, whenever the idea of a curse is explored, it follows the same pattern. We, by our own selfishness and greed, brought on the curse. What does it take to relieve the curse? Sacrifice, selflessness, love. All the things that Jesus embodied and was perfectly, which set us free from the curse that covered us. And so I feel like every time we go back and we look at those curses, we can't get away from the picture. We're under a curse, and Jesus became the curse to set us free from the curse. What did you think of Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl? What kind of ties and things do you find in that movie very fascinating? Let me know in the comments. And while you're there, tell me, how excited are you for Pirates of the Caribbean 5, Dead Men Tell No Tales? I'm pretty excited to see that movie and where they're going to take this franchise. So hit that subscribe button to become a Durbanian. Next to that subscribe button is the bell. Click the bell. That way you're notified the moment I drop more videos like theological analyses like these, or movie reviews. You can check out my movie review for King Arthur, Legend of the Sword, my movie review coming for Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales, my review for Guardians of the Galaxy, trailer reactions, and, you know, other really fun things that I love to do on this channel. Plus, if you want to get caught up on Pirates of the Caribbean and the franchise before you get to the fifth one, a great way to support Durbania, I have that Amazon Associates thing, and I have the link in my description where you could go check out the original movies and maybe purchase those through that link, which then a portion of that comes back and supports Durbania. I would greatly appreciate that if you would like to do that. Like and share this video. I'm Durbin. Thank you for checking out Durbania.